It's Bourbon Night. Hello, I'm Chad.
I'm Sarah.
And Sarah, we're in front of our bar cart right here.
This is a bar cart.
Yes, it is.
Why are we here, Chad?
Because we are giving you our top 10 or 12-ish must-have bourbons on your bar cart. Now, what we picked here is like when you're having friends over, you don't want to take them to your bourbon bunker,
depends
right?
on the friend.
Well, it depends on the friend.
But true.
We're talking about more of, you know, a casual friend or an acquaintance.
Or a buddy comes over. You want
That's
to give
true.
Them something.
Yeah. Yeah, so without taking them to where the really good stuff is, this is just going to be a nice representation of what you can have there in your living room. So that's why we picked these. We also picked the ones that are more readily available.
Mm.
Nothing too expensive, nothing too crazy. All right, so let's start it off, Sarah.
All right, so first we're gonna do some lower proof, more approachable options that, again, you should be able to go out and get pretty much right now.
So if you have like a bourbon newbie kind of come over, you don't want to fry them, they might be afraid of something high proof.
Right, so you gotta baby step them in.
Okay.
But you know what? I'm going to start with some, if we're talking about newbies, I'm gonna start with some Woodford.
Okay.
If you can go pull that off the wall.
I will pull it for you. Woodford Reserve.
The great thing about Woodford is that the flavor profile is designed to be very balanced, very in the middle of that bourbon flavor wheel.
Mm-hmm.
Not off-putting, not jutting out in one direction or another. It's a great utility bourbon. You can mix it in a drink, you can serve it neat, you can put it on the rocks and no one's gonna feel bad about that.
That's right.
It's just a really great staple to have on the bar. They've heard
so
of it.
So this is obviously staying right here on the bar card. Moving on for our second pick, again in that more like lower proof, approachable, it's one of your favorites, and that's
Ooh,
why
I know what it is.
I'm gonna pick it. It is
Evan Williams 1783.
Evan Williams 1783. Not the prettiest bottle in the world.
It's not.
Let's admit it. But this is an 86 proof. Now we didn't pick any that were just 80 proof, so there's no Basil Hayden on here. I know some people are gonna call that out in the comments below, but we feel like when you're trying to get someone into bourbon or they're just coming over, they're a casual bourbon drinker, you want something with just a little bit more personality.
Just a little zest.
That's why we like to start out at 86 proof. And this is a small batch. So this checks off a couple boxes. Readily available, low price,
very
small batch.
Very cost efficient.
Lower proof, actually checks off like four boxes.
Lots of boxes.
Right there. Going on the bar cart.
While we're in the Heaven Hill area, I'm gonna go ahead and pull something else off the wall.
Okay, where's she going?
You gotta have some Elijah Craig small batch. Again,
yes.
Another small batch. It's 94 proof. It's under $30. Delicious. I feel like you can get this most places. You can get a pick of it in a lot of places.
Yeah.
It's just a really good, sturdy staple for something that's it's not quite 100 proof, but not 80 proof either for your intermediate drinker.
Yeah, 94. You can also, if you want to kind of regale your people with a little bit of story, of course, you have the Elijah Craig story, Father Bourbon, as they call him. You can talk all about, you know, the accidental charring of the barrels.
Yes.
That old chestnut. So
it's a crowd pleaser.
Elijah Craig, going on the bar cart.
Lastly for this category, Chad, I think we have to make a trip to Buffalo Trace.
Well, we gotta, and there's so many places there that we could go.
There's so many.
With Buffalo Trace.
But we have one bar cart.
With Buffalo Trace.
Right. The flagship.
The Buffalo Trace.
Now, we would love to put Weller Special Reserve,
Weller
Eagle
Antique.
Rare, Weller Antique, Blanton's. We would love to put that on this bar card, but you go ahead and call us. Let us know where you can find all three of those, or four of those, right now. You just let me know.
For
a decent price.
For MSRP, for retail. Yeah, so coming in at 90 proof, this is anywhere from a 7 to 9-year-old blend of Buffalo Trace bourbon. This is really great stuff. It's just below Eagle Rare at, you know, 10-year age stated, but the same proof. So if you can't find Eagle Rare, you know, put this on your bar cart. If you can't find Eagle Rare, put it there. We would recommend it, but we're sticking to our guns on those availability. I know even this is kind of hard for some people to get.
Some people.
But Buffalo Trace, it's going on the bar cart.
All right, so next let's venture down the road of small batch and very flavorful. Although we do have a few small batches on here already. I want something a little more unique, something that's going to impress someone.
Sarah, I got just the
thing. Do you have it?
You know what? It's like we wrote this before, but I have it. if I can find it. Here it is. Four Roses, ooh, small batch, but wait for it, select. We would also recommend the regular small batch, which is 90 proof. Goes great with chocolate.
We have found that out.
But this is a select. It's a little bit more expensive, but you get 104 proof, you get non-chill filtered, and you get more Four Roses recipes in this one. It's new for 2019, and we are just really impressed with it, and we think your guests would be too. Just a little bit more of a kick than that regular Four Roses small batch. You could also do the single barrel from Four Roses as
well.
Oh,
you totally could.
100 proof. But we decided to go with the small batch select. It's going on the bar cart.
Yep.
Here it goes. So the bottled and bond category is, of course, a really big part of bourbon. It's the most regulated segment of bourbon that is out there. So, of course, we want at least one bottled and bond here on our bar cart.
Gotta have it.
So what are you thinking?
I mean, obviously, my heart is going for Henry McKenna single barrel.
Go grab it. Go grab it, girl. Go grab it.
I gotta get it. McKenna single barrel.
Look at this.
I mean, it's beautiful. Look at this. Mm. You get a 10-year bottled and bond single barrel for like what used to be $28. And if you had asked me 2 years ago what was the best value out there, I would have said this.
When we were.
We were saying that. Yeah. And I don't know if we contributed to the bad things, but anyways.
No.
Now that it's won all those gold medals, though.
Yeah. But before you start, you know, commenting, there's no way I can get this, or it costs triple what it used to. We're gonna set it down on the bar cart, but we're gonna put a invisible asterisk over it. Okay.
Because it does check all the boxes.
It checks a lot of boxes.
Too good to leave off.
But okay, so here's like a
caveat.
Number. What is this? Number 6.
Point two.
Yeah. And we also would have said, a little while ago, well, I guess you can see, but we would have said Heaven Hill bottled and bond, but this is the Evan Williams bottled and bond. It's kind of the replacement in our hearts for Heaven Hill bottled and bond since it's gone away.
But it's coming back. It is back now. It's about $40. It's a little bit older, a little bit wiser.
1 year older. And more money. And not in our area yet.
However,
that's why it's not on our bar cart.
Right. It's not on our bar cart, but it might be next year.
That's right.
But until then, this guy's going on there.
About $12, give or take, depending on your area. This is Kentucky Straight Bourbon Whiskey. It's bottled and bond. Good stuff, and that's why
it's going right here
by the McKenna. Going on the bar cart. There we go.
All right, Chad, so let's get into some higher proofs. Let's talk some bolder stuff. So you know, if we're going up to 100 proof, what are we gonna grab?
Well, you know it's gonna be Wild Turkey 101.
You know it's gonna be Wild Turkey
101. We're gonna go 1 point higher than these guys here.
You gotta have it. You gotta have it on the bar. Where is it? There it is.
It's right here.
Literally, the Wild Turkey staple, like the over 100 proof staple.
Yeah.
I think.
And some places it's like 1650. Other places it can be 22, 25, but still worth it. 101, higher rye recipe, not age stated, but you know, this has got some 7 years, some older there as well. It's hanging around that region. It's great stuff. We really love it. But Sarah, this is another one that's going to be like a slash.
Slash.
A one or the other.
So yeah, okay? No, totally. Like, this is my go-to at a bar, because I can get it for like $6 a pour. And it's something that I love to have on my bar cart for that reason, that it's another crowd pleaser. But if you want to kick it up just a little bit.
Bam it up a notch.
Bam.
This is Wild Turkey Rare Breed. This is barrel proof. This particular expression is 116.8 proof. And it's not that much more money. It's about double the price. It's around $35 to $40.
Mm-hmm.
But we're talking about a barrel proof. And we were talking about the category of being higher proof, bolder.
For a lot of barrel proofs, you pay upwards of $50, $60 bucks.
Yes.
So for under $40.
Yeah.
It's a good option.
Oh, and it's so good. So, it's going on the bar cart right here next to the Wild Turkey 101. These are a one or other. Don't give us too much grief about it. We do a couple like that.
Or both.
Or it's both.
It's up to you. How big is your bar cart?
There you go. All right, we have one more in kind of the bigger, bolder category. This one is probably our most expensive.
Like we said,
we try not to go too expensive for this bar cart episode, so this one is the highest. But it's from Old Forester.
Which is unlike us.
And it's our favorite date from them.
Oh, that's true. It's the 1920.
There it is.
It amazes me that you can find something like of this quality that's consistently good in this line, especially for the price. Like, it's just there. It just sits on the shelf.
Yeah, yeah. And at 115 proof, we're almost talking about the same proof as the rare breed that we're talking about. Mm-hmm. Just a little bit less proof. This isn't barrel proof, but 115 is up in that area.
Yeah, it's a sexy bottle, and it's got some really deep, like nice caramely brown sugar notes, some vanilla.
Yes.
Those normal bourbon flavors, but it's like really enriched with an extra oakiness, and it's just great. It goes on the bar cart.
Goes on the bar cart.
And it makes a great gift. So Chad, a lot of entertaining is a fair amount of cocktail making. Mixing. You gotta know how to mix at least one good cocktail,
right? I mean,
right?
When you have a friend who comes over who doesn't want it on the rocks or neat,
or someone
wants it in a cocktail,
who's never tried bourbon, who's afraid of on the rocks or neat, what are you gonna do? You're gonna give them a cocktail, and you need something bold, but that also mixes well with others.
I got something.
You got something.
I got something for you, Sarah. Boom.
All right, that's the bold one.
As you can see, you know, we enjoy it.
We like it.
Old Granddad 114. So this is a higher rye.
Mm-hmm.
This is made by Jim Beam nowadays.
That's right.
So it checks off the higher rye. So it cuts well through a cocktail.
Oh, like so well.
Yes. The higher proof, which also cuts through a cocktail well. This would be good as a neat pour for somebody, but we're putting the category of a real good base for a cocktail.
Yeah, this is like a bartender cult favorite. Like, if you ask a lot of bartenders what they like to mix, we know a lot of bartenders that like to use this. And at roughly $27 in our neck of the woods, under 30,
yeah, under
roughly
30.
$30, 114 proof, there you go.
It's going on the bar cart. Also in that area, but pulling back the proof a little bit, but also going to another category.
Okay,
I know, it's a lot of stuff.
You're making a lot of moves here, Chad.
We got larceny.
Oh, duh.
Yeah. So, okay, down to 92 proof. But really why we're putting this on the list is for the person who comes over who only drinks Maker's Mark.
Yeah. So it's soft like Maker's Mark, but it doesn't have quite such an intense sweetness.
It's a wheater.
It's a wheater. So it's got that going for it. It's a little bit less than Maker's, and it's higher proof than Maker's.
Mm-hmm.
So for that person who's just obsessed, you know, everybody knows that person that's like, I only drink Maker's.
Yeah.
And if they only drink Maker's and Coke, you can give them a larceny and Coke, and I think they're going to feel good about it.
I think so.
I think you're going to feel good about it, because I think you're going to like to drink larceny neat, and they can have it however they want it, and everyone's happy.
Well, it's got the sweetness. It's got a little bit more of the proof. A little less of the price, and it's not as sweet. So it's our preference, and maybe it might be yours too. If not, then put Maker's on your cart. But for ours and our recommendation, we're putting larceny. We're putting it on the cart.
Yep.
And lastly, sort of,
sure.
We think a barrel pick would just be the nice little coup de grace of your bar cart.
It belongs on here.
Yeah.
Like, everybody's got that local store that they always shop, and that store probably does barrel picks. It's right up there on the top shelf. Almost every store that does a barrel pick will have a Knob Creek barrel pick. And
yes,
you really can't go wrong with a Knob Creek single barrel. That 120 proof, that price point, and also the fact that it was hand selected by someone that you might know by visiting your local store.
Yeah, so, you know, we suggest going with a local store that you know that does good picks, because then you have the story of your store. You also have, as you said, a single barrel with 120 proof, another high proof one, actually our highest proof.
our highest proof of the day.
Yeah, and, you know, Knob Creek goodness.
Yeah, they say single barrels are like snowflakes. There's one and only one, and there will never be another one like it. So that's pretty cool, I think, to share with friends.
It's going on the cart.
All right, bonus time, because we got a little bit more space on here, so let's bonus it up.
Let's bonus it up. What you got?
I think something local.
Something local.
So for us,
it's all this. All this is local for
us. This is all local.
We live in Kentucky.
But for you guys, I don't know where you live, but like if you live in Texas, then there's the Iron Root. We love the Harbinger from them. Mm-hmm. If you live in Washington, there's Woodinville, and we love their stuff. That Applewood finished is amazing.
In Tennessee, maybe some
Bellmead.
Bellmead.
I don't know where you live, but I guarantee you that there is a distillery in your state. And that is so cool because it's part of your state story now.
Yeah.
And I think that you should have that on there for guests and for yourself. Like, that's, you know, repping your state.
Absolutely. Double bonus.
Double bonus.
Double bonus because we didn't put a rye on here. Ryes also work very well in cocktails. Plus, sometimes you just have a rye fan.
Sometimes you just adore rye.
We're going to go with one of our favorite ryes.
Ooh, I know what it is.
Here it is.
I'm so excited. Oh yeah, that Pikesville.
Pikesville rye. Now say what you will, this is a, as we say, barely legal rye.
Barely legal.
It's 51% rye, so it just meets that minimum of what can make a rye. So not a high rye rye.
Not a high rye rye.
But a really good rye. Basically, it tastes like a really good high rye bourbon.
It's true.
Around $50, this is 110 proof. It's made by Heaven Hill. It's the big brother to
Rittenhouse.
Thank you, Rittenhouse.
Yeah, Rittenhouse, which is also, rye. If you don't want to pull the trigger on the Pikesville, then get yourself a Rittenhouse.
But I would pull the trigger.
I would too.
All day.
A lot of people also like to use the Rittenhouse in cocktails.
Yeah.
And it's about half the price, so you don't feel so bad about mixing it.
Now, that's true.
So it depends.
This is more of a neat pour.
More of a neat pour. If you want to mix it.
Yeah, but it's going on the bar cart. Now, as we said, kind of in summing it up here, in a perfect world, we would put Blanton's on here. We would put Eagle Rare on there.
I mean, there's so many things that I would put. What would I put Elijah Craig Barrel Proof on
Elijah
here.
Elijah Craig Barrel Proof.
I would put...
We'd put some BTAC on there.
I put Booker's on here.
How about some George C. Stagg?
Yeah.
We're just getting crazy.
Right, we're just getting crazy. So, yeah, you have to draw the line.
But we're not.
There's like, because things are becoming harder to find, we wanted to make sure that we gave you a selection that is readily available, but also some great quality stuff.
It's not going to be too crowded, and we think we would have something for everyone who might come over, unless they're just a bourbon snob who will only drink like the BTAC or, you know, Pappy.
That's fine, then go to their house.
Go to their
you
house.
You get an invite to
instead.
Their house, and then they'll give you that, and then that'll be a great time too.
There you go. This episode brought to you by WhiskeyAmbitions.com. It's our home on the internet for our merch, t-shirts, glassware, and so forth. You can also become a patron.
Yep, at patreon.com/itsbourbonnight. Join in our community and conversation. Mm. Become one of our buddies.
Yeah, listen to our Patreon-exclusive podcast.
We love it.
You can also click somewhere on this screen for our most recent video, one of our favorite videos. You can click up here to subscribe, but that'll do it. Have fun with your bar cart, everyone. Thanks, Sarah.
Thanks, Chad.
Okay, and until next time, drink more bourbon.